Gordon Mwesigye, the Secretary of Uganda Human Rights Commission, says that the Commission pointed out the ambiguity of the electoral laws that do not give a clear distinction of a rally, meeting, consultations, and as well as lack of definition of the same terms.
The Uganda Human Rights Commission also notes the ambiguity of the electoral laws, which do not give a clear distinction between a rally, a meeting, or consultations, and lack clear definition of these terms. This state of affairs has exposed these laws to misinterpretation and or misuse.
Mwesigye also says that the Commission is greatly concerned with the use of unnecessary force by the police and notes that such acts violate the constitutional rights which guarantee the respect of human dignity and protection from cruel, inhumane, or degrading treatment.
The Commission is equally concerned with the growing levels of lawlessness that commonly translate itself into violent resistance of arrest. In some cases, this has regrettably involved persons one would have expected to comply with lawful orders.
Mwesigye, however, says that the Commission, as a national human rights institution, calls for the following urgent actions. Proven human rights violators should be subjected to prosecution under the new Prevention and Prohibition of Torture Act of 2012 and all subjected to administrative disciplinary sanctions, as well as compensation of victims for injury, damages, and losses suffered during the Saturday incident. Government is urged to expeditiously review and reconcile the ambiguous provisions in the Presidential Elections Act and Public Order Management Act for clarity and uniformity of interpretation. All people, irrespective of status, must fulfill their constitutional obligations to respect the law and cooperate with the law enforcement agencies. The Human Rights Commission therefore reiterates its concern about the reported actions of the police officers during the Masaka Mbarara Highway incident and reaffirms its commitment to undertaking investigations into the Saturday incident with a view of bringing the culprits to book. In a related development, the National Coordinator Human Rights Network for Journalists, Robert Sempala, has called upon police publicist Fred Enanga to withdraw his statements implicating that the media doctored the video in which an FDC supporter was stripped naked.
Certainly, every footage must be edited because you can't run a footage of 2 hours in a 10-minute bulletin. So what the police accuses the media of by saying having a biased attitude during editing is street talk. That's what uninformed people would be saying about the media who do not understand the workings of the media.
Davis Ahewi, WBS TV.